What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome back to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you guys are doing well. Thanks for taking some time out of your evening to join us. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand. Joining me as always, Ivan Lovgren. What's going on, Ivan?
Hey, just another day in paradise. It's the middle of summer. Kind of strange, huh? We're just now having opening day. We're up against opening day, Rob.
I know, right? Yeah, craziness. But the soundtrack of summer returns, so I know there's a lot of excited people. And we've got a big show planned for you guys tonight. But with the MLB season here, we figured that the Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll should be something MLB related. So we want to know, in this shortened MLB season, who's most likely to hit 400? Is it Cody Bellinger, Yordan Alvarez, Mike Trout, or other? And wow, Ivan, before we even got on the air, we had like almost 480 votes, with Mike Trout leading the way at 45.1%, Cody Bellinger in second, 25.7%, but lots of activity coming up in number three at 22.8%, with other, I mean, lots of people weighing in on it.
Yep. Greg Riemersma, I believe, well, he said none. Sorry, I misread the question there for just the slightest second. I was going to say we just had our first pitch of the season happen just a few minutes ago. So definitely somebody will have a batting average this year. But yes, will it be over 400? That's the question. A couple of Mookie Betts in there. I like that, being in Los Angeles. One, Chris Bryant. Thank you, Terry Leaders, whoever you are, wherever you are.
You made a few White Sox. Eloy Jimenez, couple people for Tim Anderson. Let's see, Christian Yelich getting some love. Who did you vote for? Did you weigh in on this?
Yeah, I voted for Bellinger. I think that with the additional help in the lineup, I think that he has the best shot there. But I'm seeing a lot of Tim Andersons. That kind of surprises me. Is that just because some White Sox account retweeted this, or what's going on with that?
I don't know.
This guy says he's a Braves fan. SP Tomahawk is a Braves fan, and he replied Tim Anderson.
Okay.
Furious George. Well, I don't know what they're a fan of, but they typed Tim Anderson.
I went with your type of thinking, but I went with Anthony Rendon.
Hitting, I was just going to say some White Sox guy over here tweeted Anthony Rendon.
Between hitting between Trout and Ohtani, I think he's going to see a lot of good pitches, and he hits for average anyway. I think it can be done. But there are a lot of people who say absolutely nobody. So we'll see. I mean, 60 games, all it takes is someone, one person, to get on a pretty good hitting streak. And you never know what will happen.
Yeah. I mean, Rob, that's my biggest gripe right now. What's been grinding my gears is, granted, I want a lot of my content just hand packaged and shoved into my timeline. I don't always have time to sit and Google and go down those rabbit holes, but I have not seen one article yet on like greatest potential 60 game seasons. Like, where are the sabermetricians that are parsing out historically what 60 games could look like? You know, like, that's what Where's that content? Have you been seeing it? I haven't been seeing it.
Well, I'll tell you why. Because it doesn't matter. Anything that happens this season gets not only an asterisk, it gets like six of them. No. So, yeah, there's like...
They're still at bats. I'm not saying season wide, and we'll debate for the rest of our lives whether the season stacks up as an MVP season or not. But I just want to see a 60 game snapshot. Those are still 60 games worth of at bats. There's still 60 games worth of pitches. Like, was there a string of 60 games where, you know, during the hit streak, what was Lou Gehrig's batting average during the hit streak? Was it 650?
You mean Joe DiMaggio?
Yeah, Joe DiMaggio, what have you. Dang it, I almost said Joe DiMaggio too, and then I second-guessed myself.
You mean Pete Rose?
This is why we need these things.
Okay. So you can keep track who had the longest hit streak before Pete Rose broke it?
No, not the longest hit streak, but just like what was the batting average during that 56, like extend it four games one way or the other, and let's figure out what the batting average was as a comp to like what could we expect this season? That's what I'm trying to get at.
If DiMaggio, during that 52 game hit streak that DiMaggio had, what was his batting average? And conversely, during 41 games for Rose, what was his batting average?
Yeah. So we can start getting an idea, 14 games, 7 games before and 7 games after sort of thing. But like, yeah, what's like the greatest 60 game number of home runs that's been hit? What's the lowest ERA anyone's ever had over 60 games? Where is that article? So if you happen to have any idea, throw some links in the chat or hit me up on Twitter or hit us both up on Twitter, because that's what I just want to see, like some context around.
You mean
what,
God forbid you have to Google something is what you're saying?
Well, yeah, I mean, it's just I started it all with, it's a lot easier if the content gets fed to me. There's a lot of other stuff to Google these days, Rob. You know, how to fix a broken clavicle is top of mind right now.
How's the little man doing?
He's doing good. Hopefully we won't have any interruptions today on the show because he's resting and not being too crazy. So I just think it'd be interesting, especially a question like that. How many 400 hitters, you know, how many people have hit 400 over 60 games versus we know in a season? It's such a rarity, you know, but over 60 games, is it somewhat common? Like, okay, what's the perspective that we should approach this season with? You know, that's all. I'm just curious on that.
Fair enough. That said,
make sure that you give us your opinion on the poll and on Ivan's thought process at twitter.com/GoGTSLive. If you're on Twitter and you normally watch the show on Twitter, send out a tweet yourself with this Twitch link or YouTube link or Facebook link to let some of your friends know, because we are not broadcasting live on Twitter as we have in the past for this
week. We're still banned.
Yeah.
We got suspended.
We think it's my fault.
Yeah.
So... it is not, though. I've been picking up that little bit too. I just tried to move it even further, but
so yeah, with over an hour left, let's see if we can get any further momentum on this poll. If any of you haven't weighed in yet, please do so. It's also the place that we are going to be drawing winners from for tonight's box breaks. So you'll want to be paying attention to the Twitter feed and retweet the tweets that Ivan tells you to. Okay.
That said, we've got a packed show tonight. We haven't even told them. We got so distracted because baseball's back, baby, and it's great. But we've got a packed, awesome show tonight, including a special announcement, an incredible guest that I begged and lobbied for last week and Rob made happen this week, and tons of good breaks and giveaways as well as previews. What are we going to do first, or do we want to?
We're going to dive right into hobby happenings, because this week's segment of news and notes from around the hobby is absolutely jam-packed. Unbelievable. It just kept coming and coming and coming.
I was going to say, thank goodness our guest is West Coast, right? Because this is long tonight, this hobby happenings. Whoa.
Absolutely. And we kick it off. Well, we'd like you to meet Parker Frederking of Wichita, Kansas. And Parker, I hear you're watching tonight, so thanks for joining us. Well, the future of the hobby is in really good hands, with young people like this already contributing in a very positive way. Watch this.
Old boy and his father are sending out packages filled with collector's items from Wichita to kids all over the country.
Yeah, this all started from one small random act of kindness that spread like wildfire. Kingsbury Smith has our story.
This stack right here.
Parker Frederking and his dad, Garrett, focused on making the most of quarantine together.
A couple pieces of cardboard cut out, please.
My dad connected to a lot of people on Twitter, and people have been sending him texts about, like, their kid's favorite team, and we've been sending them cards like that.
After a surgery Parker had, someone sent him a box of sports cards. He knew he wanted to pay it forward. And as of today, he sent over 100 shipments, at least one to all 50 states and Canada.
Just to be kind and generous to other kids who might not have very much things.
With him being a big brother through foster care, he's learned, you know, that there's some kids out there that just don't have a lot. He's always had a big, generous heart, looks out for others.
Parker and his dad then send their packages, usually several at a time. And this can get pretty expensive, but he has had some help financially.
I was just in a shout out Midwest Box Breaks because they gave me these big sticker boxes to send out to kids with the cards.
Along with businesses and people donating boxes of cards and other items, an anonymous donor from New York sent Parker $250.
It's just been one small act of kindness has led to two, which has led to four, and it's just each act has continued to pay its way forward, and that's been really, really amazing to see.
Garrett says he's inspired by his son and his willingness to help.
John's is done.
How can you not be proud of your kid that he wants to be kind to others and wants to bring a smile to somebody's face with everything that's going on today?
We'll probably be doing a lot more of this kind of things in the future.
In Wichita, Bree Smith, Cake News on your side.
Well, Parker, we absolutely love what you're doing, and we want to help ensure that you always have plenty of cards to ship. So here's the deal. Starting tomorrow, we'll be periodically sending you all the cards we don't give away on this show to help with your efforts. After I talked to your dad, he hooked me up with the address, got a package all ready to go for you. So thank you, Parker, for being a light in the darkness, and keep doing what you're doing.
That's awesome. Another fresh to the hobby collection is headed to auction. Sports Collectors Daily reports that a Chicago area family has turned over their late father's remarkable old school collections, a collection of thousands of early baseball cards, to Robert Edward Auctions. The collection features thousands of baseball cards spanning the 1880s up to the 1940s, with a heavy emphasis on N172 Old Judge cards. No, not Aaron Judge, Old Judge. As well as 1910 era tobacco and caramel cards. REA President Brian Dwyer said, quote, "This is a very special collection that we are thrilled to have been chosen to bring to market on behalf of the family. The quality and variety of 19th century cards really makes this collection stand out. But every page of this collector's binders yielded something noteworthy. It is so exciting to see a fresh collection with such significant highlights unearthed after decades in the shadows, and we are confident that collectors will appreciate the opportunity to add these cards to their collections." Bidding in Robert Edwards Auctions summer auction will open July 24th, hey, that's tomorrow, and runs through August 16th. Registration to bid is now open online as well at www.robertedwardauctions.com.
Well, a Florida couple made a storage unit purchase that ended up containing memorabilia from former Orlando Magic All-Star Nick Anderson. Apparently, the unit had been rented by Anderson's ex-wife, ouch, who stopped paying the bill. The items have been bulk listed on the Facebook marketplace with an asking price of $35,000. So I guess good luck with that.
Hey, do you live in Southern California and want to work in the hobby? Well, then good news. Ultra Pro is currently seeking applicants for a key account manager, a position that requires no cold calling and is a salaried position starting at, get this, $60,000 to $65,000 per year. If interested, see their listing on ZipRecruiter.com. No excuses. You can work in the hobby.
No doubt. That seems like a really nice job, actually. Well, tightly wrapped and still looking just as they did when they left the packaging plant 40, 50, 60 years ago or more, a massive collection of vintage unopened packs and boxes offered in a major catalog auction will once again beg the question, to open or not. Sports Collectors Daily reports that Heritage Auctions' newly launched summer trading card auction includes over 80 lots of unopened material, including some of the most popular boxes in the current marketplace. The auction marks the second time, actually, in 7 months that Heritage has offered literally dozens of vintage boxes and packs in a single auction. Every major sport is represented, and there are also some non-sport boxes and packs as well. Scheduled auction closes July 30th and 31st.
Well, we have to apologize quickly for missing this story last week, but apparently last weekend was Upper Deck Family Weekend. What does that mean? Well, that means that collectors who spent $25 on Upper Deck hockey cards at participating shops received a free 8-card sibling sensation set. And so while you could go out online and just buy those sets now, if you did miss it, check with your LCS first, because some of them may have extra sets with attendance from COVID and shelter at home being a little bit lower. So check with your LCS, see if they have any extra sets, and maybe you can get your hands on one of those and pick up some of the hot Upper Deck hockey cards. Pretty awesome promotion.
Absolutely. I know I saw a couple tweets about that. There are shops with leftovers. Excuse me. In all the hype and hoopla surrounding Topps Project 2020, it would be easy to miss or simply forget the existence of one of the company's other on-demand offerings. 2020 Topps Game Within the Game Baseball is another in a growing number of online-only living type sets, in the sense that they're ongoing. But instead of offering new cards daily or even weekly, it is an almost monthly, every 28 days, drop of just one card. Ryan Cracknell at Beckham Media says that the set features the work of Paul Jennis. And the painting on each card has two different images of each player. They're really beautiful. There's a sense of realism to his work, but the colors and style add some additional modern flair. There have been 6 cards previously released, all with print runs ranging from 2,200 to almost 3,100. This week, Shohei Ohtani is added to the checklist. Individual cards cost just $7.99 with bulk discounts available.
Panini also released its latest online offering this week in the form of Immaculate Hockey, featuring cards of top prospects Kaapo Kakko and Vitaly Kravtsov. Each $150 pack contains 2 cards, every card numbered to 99 or less, and each pack is guaranteed to include 1 rookie patch autograph signed on card, and then 1 jumbo or dual jersey card. Quantities are limited, so go ahead and act fast on those.
Well, back in 2003-2004, numerous people in the hobby had an absolute conniption fit when Upper Deck released Exquisite Basketball with an SRP of $500. Well, looking back, it seems like a steal. Well, especially with this particular card selling last week for $1.8 million, which included the buyer's premium. The rookie parallel of LeBron James' most coveted rookie card. It's limited to just 23 copies, with this one being numbered 14 of 23. It's graded Gem Mint 9.5 by Beckett Grading and now holds the record for the most valuable trading card of the modern era. Absolutely incredible. Darren Revelle tweeted that the person who purchased the card, Lior Avidar, said that the purchase is part of a strategy to bring something big to the collectibles and alternative asset business in the coming months. According to Avidar's Twitter profile, he is the CEO and co-founder of Lob.com and is a professional collector, flipper, and negotiator of random things who loves curating experiences and helping people build companies. Fractional shares, anyone? I don't know.
Well, Rob, if you think $1.8 million is a lot, I've got a question for you. Do you want to see what nearly $6 million in modern sports cards looks like?
Well, duh.
Okay, check this out. These two slides show sales from recent Golden Auctions events over the last few years with their realized prices, not including the $1.8 million LeBron. And as a collector and not a flipper, which one would you want for your PC?
Good question, but that's easy for me. That Jordan rookie. Give me the Jordan rookie.
All right. Well, that was easy, but hey, Rob.
Uh-huh.
Have you heard about this?
I might have heard a little something.
All right. Well, you heard a little something. We've got the full scoop for you. Obviously, a lot of people, including you viewers, including myself, and I'm sure Rob, are bummed about there not being a national this summer. Biggest sports card show of the year not happening this summer, unfortunately. So the guys over at Bench Clear Media have put together a hobby media event unlike any other. It's going to start at 2 p.m. next Friday, July 31st, and it's going to run through 9 p.m. Sunday, August 2nd. So that's 3 days featuring some of the greatest content creators in the hobby. They'll all be bringing their thing to a worldwide audience in a live streaming event for the ages. Stay tuned for more details or visit www.thehobbypalooza.com.
And as an amendment to that story, after this was published, we were invited to participate in Hobbypalooza. So yes, Go GTS Live will be part of this. You can catch us at 9 Eastern on Friday the 31st.
I heard we're going to have a controversial guest do some real hot seat action.
I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. But we'll also have our regular show on that Thursday as well. So we'll fill you more in that.
I'm not very good at winking.
Well, yeah, that's awesome. So, hey, Ivan.
Yes, Rob.
Have you ever seen this product in the wild?
Not that I can recall.
Okay. Well, check out
there's been a lot of stuff throughout the years, though, on those repack shelves.
Well, check out this story from Anson Whaley's The Wayback Collector segment on Sports Collectors Daily. This product, Gems of the Game, is a repack product that typically includes several packs of previously released trading cards, along with a single graded card that serves as the hit. They're created by retail distributor MJ Holding Company and are really just a clever way of selling unsold packs of other product. However, among the graded cards inserted into boxes this year are genuine E98 caramel cards that have been graded by Beckett. The E98 set included a total of 30 cards and is believed to have been distributed in around 1910. And you might remember that a few years ago that these cards gained notoriety with the discovery of what ended up being $3 million worth of high-graded examples in what was dubbed the Black Swamp Find in Ohio. So, imagine collector Justin Quaid of Minnesota's surprise when he pulled this from the $19.99 box. A Johnny Evers graded in an 8.
Whoa.
Okay, so the last two examples to sell on eBay in that grade went for $9.32 and $9.70 respectively. Not a bad return on a $20 blaster. I'll take that all day long. But not limited to just the States, apparently. Collector Costas Kladinos of Oakville, Canada, which is near Toronto, pulled this card of Hal Chase, also graded in an 8. And while there aren't any recent sales for comparison, two are currently listed on eBay with an average price of around $800. Now, I'm not saying go scarf up as many as you can find, but I think it makes for a pretty cool treasure hunt. And if you're into pre-war cards or just want to learn more, be sure to give Anson on Twitter a follow, conveniently enough, at Pre-War Cards.
Good handle. Good handle. Yesterday, the website Sports Hiatus hosted an interesting webcast. Hosted by Kenny Main, the topic focused on the resurgence and future of sports collectibles. Notable panelists included former MLB pitcher and well-known vocal collector Phil Hughes, Jeff Heckman, the director of global e-commerce at Tops, and Katie Tedman, the head of marketing and partnership at Dapper Labs, who is an active developer in the digital collectibles space for the NBA. The replay is available on demand on the Sports Hiatus website, so be sure to check it out.
I watched it. It was pretty good. Upper Deck has announced that they have signed top high school prep basketball player Jalen Green to an autograph and trading card deal. However, the deal makes no mention of an exclusive, which is good news for Panini and NBA fans, as he is widely anticipated to be the number one overall pick in the 2021 NBA draft. Here's more from Upper Deck.
I was rocking 23s all through like elementary school, and 23 is my number because of Michael Jordan. And then I switched to 4. My mom wore 14, so I just wore 4, took the one up. My mom sacrificed a lot for me to get to the point where I'm at right now. She played the dad and mom role. I was rocking the unicorn thing all through high school, but you know, anybody could call themselves a unicorn. And it was just meaning like you're different on and off the court. I really don't even rep that no more just because so many people tried to claim me and take over. And anybody could be called a unicorn at this point. I just kind of just rock being different now. So I don't really say unicorn, I just say I'm different. But I was always playing like football, track, soccer, tennis. My mom wanted me and everything. I would tell my 8-year-old self to just keep working. Keep your head on tight, stay in school. You're gonna find a sport.
Sometimes we reserve comment until the details are all out, especially when it involves federal investigations. And sometimes justice moves slowly, really slowly. Remember this guy? This is Tony Posada, who you may recall was kicked out, or I should say escorted out of the 2018 National Sports Collectors Convention by authorities for selling forged autographed memorabilia. Sports Collectors Daily reports now that on April 27th of this year, Posada was indicted by an Ohio grand jury on numerous charges, including forgery, petty theft, criminal simulation. and 25 counts of trademark counterfeiting, since some of the items in his inventory carried what prosecutors say were phony MLB trademarks. The indictment centers on one transaction that took place not long after the show opened, in which a Louisiana collector purchased 7 items with a total of 12 allegedly forged signatures of Roger Maris, Mickey Mantle, Billy Martin, Ed Cranepool, Roberto Clemente, Ernie Banks, Sandy Koufax, and Joe DiMaggio. All were immediately dismissed by a professional authenticator at the show as being forged. Posada entered a plea of not guilty and is free on bail awaiting trial. And so while these things take time, we will get you the details as they come to light.
Sooner or later. Well, if you love Onyx baseball products like we do, here's a great opportunity through Dave and Adams. From now through July 31st, for each box purchased of 2020 Onyx Premium Vintage Premium Collection, rather, you'll receive an entry to win all 3 of these autograph cards, one of Wander Franco, Marco Luciano, and Bobby Witt Jr. Pretty cool. So if you're planning on picking it up anyway, might as well get it at Dave and Adams.
In some other exciting auction news, Heritage Auctions' Summer Sports Card Catalog Sale is almost always epic. But with the red-hot market and collections crawling out of the woodwork, this year's should be especially exceptional. If you're interested in getting a glimpse of what's in store for the July 30th event, be sure to tune in to their Zoom virtual auction preview on July 24th at 12 p.m. Central Time. A virtual walkthrough. Sounds pretty fun.
Just when you thought the modern card hysteria couldn't get any crazier, with recent sales of a 2009 Bowman Chrome Draft Mike Trout Red Refractor autograph graded BGS 9.5 selling in May for $922,500, only to be topped last week with the sale of that Upper Deck Exquisite LeBron James RPA parallel number to 23, setting the new record for the sale of a modern trading card at almost $1.85 million. It would make sense, you would think, that the LeBron RPA would hold that record, at least for a little while, right? Well, not so fast. Not so fast. Now comes word that the 2009 Bowman Chrome Draft Mike Trout Refractor Auto will be part of Golden Auction's Golden Elite Sales Event, which opens July 28th, next week, and runs through Saturday, August 2nd. But check this out. Bidding for the card starts at a cool $1 million. Now, you might remember that the card's consigner, Dave Owensia, a.k.a. Vegas Dave, purchased the card and has industry experts predicting that in all likelihood, the card that he purchased on eBay, the exact same one 2 years ago for $400,000. Well, at the time, many questioned the card's seemingly inflated value, but Vegas Dave had a plan, saying at the time, I won't sell it until I can sell it for the highest price of any card ever sold. So here's the deal. Many experts have been talking behind the scenes and believe that, yes, now is the time. And it's widely suspected not only to surpass the LeBron James card, but has an outside chance of actually breaking the all-time record ever paid for a trading card, which happens to be this holy grail that also coincidentally sold through Golden Auctions in 2016 for $3.12 million. So the question is, will Vegas Dave get the last laugh? I guess we'll soon find out. Pretty interesting. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.
Wow.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I mean, I remember at the time people just were trolling him and why wouldn't I pay it? You know, it's the most blah, blah, blah. I mean, it was just, it got the dander up of a lot of people. It also got a lot of kudos from other people. It was a well-talked about subject just 2 years ago. And now people are speculating, can it break Honus's long-held record? Incredible.
I mean, it is the one of one. And we've seen the premium, you know, that carries a number to 23 LeBron selling for almost $2 million.
Yeah, and almost $1 million for the Trout numbered one of five. So I that's going to make a great story regardless of what happens. So, and man, Golden Auctions, every single one of those cards we showed you earlier in that segment, all sold through Golden Auctions. While Heritage is one of the biggest and has lots of different categories, I swear, Golden seems to land some of the most unbelievable single cards in the hobby's existence.
So here's a question, though, Rob.
Okay.
You know, let's be honest here. Let's not conflate things or inflate things. If experts are telling him now is the time to sell, is that simply because they think now it will surpass that, or are they thinking that now is the height of that?
Explain your differentiation between those two.
So is it that now is the moment where it finally could surpass it, and so that's why they're saying sell, or is it, hey, this is the top for that card? Not that it could surpass the Honus Wagner alone.
I don't think it has to be one or the other, does it? Could it be a combination of the two?
It could. I'm also, I mean, you've probably seen me over the last year sort of shift my bearish stance in general because of behavioral economics. I don't believe that there's a scientific point at which the, you know, cost to value ratio is off. I believe that it has to do with when people stop participating in the hobby more than it has to do with
absolutely
value. So I don't know how you could predict that. But some people think they are great at predicting things like that, and some people might actually be. I don't know.
I think when you get to that level of collectibles that are so beyond your and I's understanding, if you will, because it just it's a tangible asset at that point. It's no longer a trading card. It is, you know, something that goes in a financial portfolio, right? So I think you're dealing with a whole different mentality and segment of buyer who really probably isn't a collector. You know, they're more like Ben Affleck and the accountant who opens that drawer and he's got a Honus Wagner and he's got a, you know, number one action comic Superman and, you know, tangible assets he can get rid of for cash right away.
Here's something I would actually argue with you on that, Rob, is that I don't necessarily know. I do believe in a lot of big money at the top. We've seen that with, you know, Nats Turner, for example. You know, obviously Gary Vaynerchuk, Phil Hughes, you know, multi-millionaires, verging on billionaires in some cases. Plus 50 Cent, huge collector. Tracy Morgan, huge collector of various memorabilia. Just saying, there's a lot of people out there with a lot of money. But what we are also seeing is because of the amount of conversation around these as assets, you're seeing companies like StockX that come up and create new arbitrage opportunities. And what was the other one that does the parceling of the cards?
The fractional shares.
Yeah, fractional shares.
The blue chip whatever, collectibles, yeah.
Whatever that is that you're looking at, obviously there's a premium built in for bringing the access down to either the accredited investor level or the lower level investor. You know, you're paying a premium to be able to buy a piece of something. So that actually creates an interesting market for the high-end collectibles to be valued higher, because then they can still actually, you know, they don't need four people in the world to be vying for them. They're selling pieces of them to me and you, and they're able to charge a markup. So that also could be another side of it. Just to be fair to, you know, I'm not necessarily saying it's a sign that we're at a peak. There's, you know, it just depends on what people are going to spend money on, you know.
Absolutely.
But it's interesting. Never stop thinking about it.
No.
Always question the truth.
And I think it is really interesting when you have that big money at the top. But I don't know. It just it's in a different stratosphere, you know. It's like sorting through the dime box versus, you know.
Yeah, but
a whole
who was
other
the first
level.
Who is the first person to hit that Mike Trout Bowman Chrome Superfractor?
Yeah, probably just a Joe, right?
Quite possibly. I did see an interesting story on Instagram. I'm not sure if it's 100% true, but someone wrote out a pretty long story on Instagram with that post of the LeBron saying that they used to own it, that they paid, you know, X amount of thousands for it, and they sold it to another guy for $40,000, and they're happy to see him do this, you know. And so there's an interesting chain of ownership to these things too, where it's not like Vegas Dave just woke up with it one day.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So.
Absolutely. Well, we are going to be joined momentarily by Tony Sirianni from Upper Deck, who is and actually has been the product development lead for a few years now on Ivan's favorite product, Goodwin Champions. And Tony's going to sit in and talk with us a little bit about this year's Goodwin, and then he's going to hang out while we break two boxes of the product so he can provide some insight and details into what we have coming out of our own box breaks. Welcome to Go GTS
so,
Live.
Tony,
how you
welcome
doing, sir? To Go
What's
GTS
up, guys?
Live.
How are you
Thanks doing, sir?
Me on.
Hey, it's an absolute pleasure. Thanks for taking
hey,
some time out of your schedule.
Hey, it's an absolute pleasure.
Thanks for taking some time out of your schedule. Ivan asked me last week, he said,
Goodwin,
can we get the guy who
the
does
show?
And I said, yeah, I can probably make that happen. The show? And I said, yeah,
and
I can probably make that happen.
And I was hoping it was you, Tony.
Yeah, I temporarily
forgot for a minute that it was you.
Yeah, I temporarily forgot for a minute that it
was
you, so I hit Carlin up, and here's Tony when he replied back to me.
Yeah.
So... give us give us a little bit of, I mean, what's this brand about? Why have you been attached to it? What do you love about it? Why is it your baby, and why collectors are going to love it?
Yeah. You know, I've been lucky enough to work on the set now for, 4 years. And this is always Grant's baby. Grant Sandground, director of product development. He's the one who kind of came up with this brand years ago and has just kind of watched it grow and groomed it and kind of just, been there along the way to help us build the set. But yeah, it's so fun. You know, obviously we love our hockey. We make a lot of NHL, but it's fun to do something a little different outside the box. And Goodwin basically fills all of those buckets. You have multi-sport, entertainment, pop culture, history, a little bit of education. So yeah, it's just a lot of fun. One of my favorites to work on for sure.
One of the things I wanted to ask you, I saw a picture of a Wayne Gretzky card. Okay. He was pictured in a suit. And I said, that's interesting. They have right. the NHL license. Why would they not picture him in uniform? Was sure. that because of continuity from a design standpoint, because of some other people that couldn't be in uniform?
Yeah, it's a great question. Goodwin Champions, we try to differentiate it again from the NHL sets. You really don't see like any active NHL players in it anymore. We try to keep that separate as a special thing for those sets. And then kind of Goodwin, we go outside that. I mean, Wayne is a special case. We're never going to say no to putting Wayne and Goodwin. We love having them in there.
So do collectors.
Yeah, just for like a design continuity, everyone's kind of in, street clothes or not what you're used to seeing them in a game, when you're watching your favorite athletes. So yeah, just to kind of keep it consistent, that's a good way to put it. Yep.
Nice. Now I know that there's some crossover, not like we've seen from some other bigger products, but tell us a little bit about the inserts and bringing the Exquisite brand into Goodwin Champions.
Yeah, good stuff, of course, Ivan. I mean, the product's been out now for, almost 2 days. And, there's always a lot of surprises. And I'm sure you guys are seeing all these awesome Exquisite cards. The Dominguez, the Joe Burrows, Megan Rapinoe, Alex Morgan. I mean, we got a lot of really, really nice names in there. Wander Franco's in there. He's a redemption, but we'll have those back soon. So yeah, it's loaded up with those kind of case hits everyone's been looking for. But yeah, not making a standalone basketball product right now, it makes sense to include it in Goodwin, to kind of feature all of the athletes that we have in our stable. So it just kind of made sense to bring that brand over there to just kind of to add that excitement. When we first did it with that Ben Simmons card, that was just like a huge, huge thing a few years ago. And then, of course, we've continued it with Ohtani, Luca, and then this year with some of those other names I mentioned. So, yeah, it's found a really nice home there. For collectors to still go after those Exquisite cards that everybody loves. I mean, the brand is, we've seen what just happened with that LeBron card. So it's pretty incredible, the market for the Exquisite brand. So yeah, we love having it in there.
And then you surprised everyone with a little Jalen Green.
Yes. Yes. That was a nice new, we did the press release too. Upper Deck is very excited to have Jalen Green on board. Just prospecting these athletes, getting ahead of it before, they make their big decision. There's a lot of things changing with these athletes as far as the college rules and having to go to the NBA or going to college for a year before you go to the NBA. Now with these new rules in place, they can go play in the G League. And, from there, they can get 1 year of development. It's almost like a minor league for the NBA. Sure. So it's cool to have these guys have a different way to go about, becoming professionals in the league. So yeah, we're real excited. Jalen Green is already being compared to some pretty big names, five-star recruit. He's going to be probably, I've seen him everywhere from 1 to 3, but he's going to be a stud next year. So it's exciting to have his first cards this far ahead. So yeah, it's pretty exciting.
So wait, you're saying he actually is in Goodwin Champions? It's not just the announcement?
He is in Goodwin Champions. His first card is in 2020 Goodwin Champions. Yep, that's right.
Because I was just searching. That's what I thought you said. So I went on the internet to search, and I have not seen one pop up yet on the internet sales site, of course, eBay.
I saw a few. Oh, yeah. I did see a few pop up on release day quickly, and they were sold almost immediately. So if you search eBay under sold listings for Jalen Green, you might see a few pop up, but they are in there. So happy hunting. Maybe you'll find one tonight. Who knows? I'm excited to see what you guys have in those boxes. I haven't seen the product live myself. And again, I love this set. So I can't wait to see what you guys think of it when you open it. That's always one of the most fun experiences, obviously, you guys know, is the opening experience. So, no, that's awesome. But, yeah, look for Jalen Green.
How does this make you feel, Tony? One sold today for $280.
That's great. Yeah. I mean, again, just to kind of get ahead of it, you know, you had the Zion hype about a year or so before, even, you know, Duke, people were so hyped with him. So, you know, just collectors and sports, you know, fans in general, everyone just kind of getting ahead of it and starting to see, find these athletes a little earlier. And again, like I said, with the rules changing with the college eligibility, I think you're going to see it even more and more. You'll see these younger athletes kind of being found and scouted. So yeah, it's exciting. I mean, Dominguez is a great example of that as well. You know, I think he's what, 17 now at this point. And, you know, obviously we'll see what he's doing. I don't think he's 18 yet, but the Yankees have high hopes and, you know, all the collectors do as well. So it's really great. It's a great thing for the hobby.
Yeah, he's a young 17, just turned 17.
There you go.
Four months ago. So, hey, I have another question about building a product like this and your own personal fandom. Feel free to insert what's exciting for you.
Yeah.
You know, we can talk about the basketball players and the baseball players, you know, the hot prospects there. But this product is what I call eclectic, where it has a wide variety of athletes, entertainers, performers of all types. Talk a little bit about the process of deciding who to include and then going after them. And is there anybody super special to you or to collectors this year?
Okay. Yeah. Great question again. Yeah. So, I mean, it's a long process. I mean, Goodwin Champions, like, it takes everybody at Upper Deck to make that product, you know, to make it go, to get it out the door. I mean, it starts, with the concepts, the theming, but then a big part of it, like we were talking about, you know, we don't put the NHL players in there. We don't lean on another league or license to fulfill the checklist. So we go out and we find 50, you know, or so unique names every year. And it's a group of us internally, but, you know, we love to get feedback externally too of any names that you collectors would love to see. We're always open to ideas and new names with that. But yeah, it's a long process of, you know, brainstorming, coming up with a really rather large list, and then it just kind of narrows down. You know, it takes about 13 months or so to produce a product like Goodwin. So it's funny that we're at the release of 2020 and our heads internally, we're all working on 2021 right now. But as far as names this year that I'm proud that we've gotten, you know, having a mix of like the top sports names to me is a collector. That's just, you know, that's what you're looking for in a set. So you've got your top football guys, you know, with Burrow. You have top baseball names right now with Dominguez and Franco. Obviously, the basketball names with Upper Deck's spokesman. And as we've talked about, the new guys like Green. We have a little bit of hockey in there with Wayne Gretzky. We got Man in Rome representing, like, you know, some of the female athletes, legendary goalie. Some of the soccer players. So yeah, I'm really proud this year of just the diversity of names. Like, we just have such an assortment of just, you know, big time collectible athletes across the board. I'm really happy with that. I love some of the smaller names. You know, I like seeing the Mark Henrys and the Vince Russos. I like seeing the Milton from Office Space with the My Stapler inscription, you know, stuff like that. Like we have Danny Trejo. That was one we worked hard to get him in there. And there's a version with a machete inscription. So like I love that. Awesome. Like, that's one of my favorites. So just a lot, any, you know, anything and everything in Goodwin. You just never know what you're going to find. So yeah, those are probably some of my favorites this year.
Well, right off the bat, I couldn't wait anymore. I opened the box and I just want to make sure there's no cards hidden in the lid, right? Like,
we haven't tried that one yet. No, we haven't tried the lid trick. I remember a lot of people were destroying cards and throwing boxes away. So yeah, we haven't tried that one, but I give it to them for the creativity with that as far as a hidden item. But no, you're good with your box. You can get rid of the box. It's a nice looking box, but you know, nothing hidden in there, I promise.
I love right away that you tell people that there is a bounty program, and yep, for 25 collectors to complete the 50 card splash of color lenticular bounty set, yep, will win a splash of color Tiger Woods autograph. That's
yep. Awesome. Oh yeah. Yeah. Awesome. So, we've been doing the bounty program on this for a few years. We also do in some of our hockey sets, but yeah, it's just a way to encourage set collecting. We want to, you know, encourage collectors getting together maybe with their local shop and, you know, everybody, let's put together the bounty. We've seen people do that on the hockey side with like our SP Authentic bounty, and they'll get a group together and let's all put this set together, and then we'll, you know, we'll split the prize, or, you know, some of our bounties, you get more than one card, so it's easier to split. But yeah, it's just, you know, you put this set together. There'll be lenticulars with and without scratch codes. And the ones with the scratch codes are going to be the ones tied to the bounty. So those are even more valuable. And you're going to want to hold on to it. But yeah, if you put together that 50 card set, upperdeckbounty.com is the website. You just go there, enter your codes, and once you have the full set, you'll, if you're one of the first 25, you'll get that Tiger Woods autograph that's only available via the bounty. So
this card, really cool, Tony,
really
this
cool
card
program. Yeah.
Tony, this card screams, put an auto right here.
Yeah, that's pretty well done with his, with that white podium there. I agree.
Yeah, right?
You know, the cool thing with the Goodwin stock is those cards are great to get signed in person. So, you know, you go run into Butchergross, just have them sign it right there. you know, we kind of build those cards that way. They don't have the UV that will cause issues with autographs. So, yeah, these are good ones. You can go get that signed. Tiger won't be able to sign, but
yeah, Tiger won't.
Now, that'd be pretty awesome, though, to get Tiger Woods to sign that. Did you guys, yeah, are there any randomly inserted Tiger cards?
I love that. Those unique items for the collection. I love it.
Tell me about this mini. It's almost got a wood texture, and yep, it's a lumberjack back.
That's right. Yeah, our lumberjack mini. Yep, that's right. It has like a feel of like a wood feel grain to it. Those
nice.
Are pretty tough. Yeah, that you might get one or two of those per box.
So as a reminder, if you're opening a box and you're as lost as we are and you don't have Tony from Upper Deck on the phone, you can go to gogts.net and download the entire checklist, which also includes, I believe, odds. Oh, this one doesn't. It doesn't include odds on this one. Let me go check the Excel version. But you can see which ones are the more rare memorabilia pieces, so on and so forth, and see the entire checklist of names here. But historically, because of the fact that the Goodwin set, it's like it's 100 cards, right? But there's, well, do you consider it 100 cards or 50 cards?
Yeah, so your main base is going to be 100 cards. But yeah, I can see where you're confused with that, Ivan, because what
I'm
it is.
I'm just asking for definitions because I always say the wrong things and people get mad at me. It's not a patch. It's a twitch.
Yeah, no, it's 50 vertical and then 50 horizontal. So like Jordan has two base cards. LeBron has two base cards. That was a beautiful splash of color. There
yes,
you go.
Perfect. It was.
So Joe Burrow, that's his horizontal, but he'll also have a vertical with a different photo. So yeah, it's just two base cards. So 100 cards make up your base set for Goodwin. And then you also have your Gaudis and your Splash of Color. So Splash of Color are considered part of the base set. Those are going to be 101 through 150. And then the Gaudis, I think, are G1 through G50. So it's like a subset.
Now, yeah, exactly. How rare are those Splash of Colors there?
Splash of Color, you'll probably get 3 or 4 per box. Same thing with your Gaudi. That's just like they're like a subset within the grouping. But yeah, the nice looking design. I love the Gaudi design. I thought we really revamped that. Goodwin,
we've pops.
Really tried to modernize the design. You know, it had a very, you know, old traditional look, and we've more of like a tobacco card look. We're trying to modernize it more and more. We still keep those historic elements, but oh yeah, there we go. You got Stevie Wise. We got World Champ Softball. There's quite an assortment of sports in here, like I said.
And no, I saw.
And musicians, like right on cue here.
Yeah, I saw earlier Ryan Stasek, and there's another one. That's just who I was going to bring up. A bit of an eclectic choice for a musician as well. What sort of led to that?
So last year we had a lot of success with the band 311. We had the entire band in the set. There was a rabid fan base of collectors of cards as well as of that band that kind of started collecting from it. So we've just been kind of looking around, thinking of other bands, trying to see other bands that might be interested in doing that. They've seemed to value out pretty well, and collectors have enjoyed that. So we're just going to continue that to see. Some musicians in the set from year to year if possible. But just different ideas, kind of bouncing those ideas off between the group of us. Brian and Danny, and that was a Patrick, who's a big music guy. He said, Humphreys McGee's a really big band. They have a lot of big fan base, rabid following. And, sure enough, we contacted them, and some of their band members, new trading cards. So they said, yeah, let's do it. We'd love to have a card. So it's awesome when you see these cards on the secondary market that, value out higher than, some people are expecting, or some of the athlete cards. So it's pretty awesome to go into those different realms of fandoms.
He's even got a Gaudi version.
There you go. That's right.
I do like that you include Will Power. Yeah, I'm a big fan of open wheel racing. So thanks for the nod to Will Power there.
Oh, of course. Yeah. Then there's Steven Root. There's my guy from Office Space I was talking about. Love that guy.
He's also in a great show on Amazon Prime called Man in the High Castle. Have you seen that?
Okay. I've heard good things about that one. I haven't watched it yet.
Yeah, it's a good one.
I know you guys are movie fans, film fans. I'm halfway through Knives Out right now.
I haven't dove into that yet. I've
enjoyed it. Yeah, I'm intrigued to see the second half, but it's lived up to the hype. It's really good.
By halfway check out through, this card, does that mean that you have children?
No, no children yet. Just the dog, just the fur baby. He's hanging out, sleeping on the bed behind me here.
Because I was like, there's halfway through a movie is something cards. that I'm familiar with.
Yeah, I get pulled into, other fun things like, Goodwin Champs trading cards, and baseball's back, and hockey's almost back. So I'm all over the place getting excited with all the different things that are coming back to our lives right now. So, yeah, I'm like, I'll finish this movie later. I've watched about 100 movies since I've been out of work. So taking it slow with that one, enjoying it. There's Man in Rome. That's who I was talking about, the goalie. So check out the back of this lenticular you pulled. Let's see if you got one with or without a code on the back. So I can kind of show these guys what to look for.
Without.
Okay, yeah, so you got the Willpower. This is a non-coded version, but you'll see kind of below the text, there's going to be versions that'll have a barcode, scratch code. And those are the ones that you're going to want to look for with the bounty. Yep, exactly. Right there, you'll see a scratch code. So just a little something extra to look for on those cards. Those lenticulars look great. Those 3Ds, they really pop.
And turn them. And I love the really rounded corners.
Now I'm seeing
yeah,
this.
That was a nice difference with the rounded corners. We changed it up a little bit.
Just that I'm seeing that there's three tiers of lenticular. There's tier one, which are one in about 1.5 boxes. Tier two, which seem to be one per 169 packs. You can do the math on how many boxes that is. And tier three is one in 675 packs. Now those codes, though, are there odds for the bounty codes too, or is it just certain tiers of the?
It's a lower percentage. The one thing we did though is if you hit a higher tier bounty card, it has a much higher percentage chance of having a code, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
I believe those percentages or those ratios are out there. To look for those, but I can try to get you more info on that. But to answer your question, It is a lot. It is tougher. But as the card gets more difficult, we gave the a larger amount of codes because of that reason.
Right. I love these now, cards too. I am not a cat fan, but I do know that they are going to be extremely popular with some people. And that's why you, you know, you have dog people and you have cat people. You did dogs for a couple years, kind of, you know, went through that, and I guess it's only fair to get the give the cat people what they want. So there is one of our patch cards. The lenticular card is considered a hit as well, correct?
That's correct.
Okay. So we've got, Ivan, two cards to give away so far.
Now, here's the other thing, though, with these cat, dog, et cetera cards is, again, this is one where you're going to want to go to the checklist, go to the insert checklist, because, Rob, I'm with you. I am not a cat person, but, you know, nothing before the butt matters, right? But that was a caracal. I'm not sure how you pronounce it, but they're an exotic cat. That's not a house cat.
Wow, who likes American Ninja Warrior? My kids are addicted to that show. There's Joe Morawski. Auto.
And that's
it's a beautiful on-card autograph right there.
Yeah, we've been, it's been great to go into, again, those kind of realms, like television shows that, you know, again, these guys are athletes too. So it's been awesome. We've had a few American Ninja Warriors and they've done really well. Collectors have enjoyed having them in there. So yeah, I'm glad you enjoy that. It's awesome. I think he did some nice inscriptions for us too, so for some of his achievements on the show.
Well, he certainly had plenty of them.
Right.
I know my kids will know right away who that is.
That's awesome. I love it.
So Rob, I know you think that's awesome, but I'm an odds chaser. So I'm going to go back to what I was looking at. I had to look it up anyways. But yeah, so get this. That Caracal, Caracal, somebody let me know how to pronounce that, is a tier 3 cat hit.
Yeah.
So that's actually 1 in 704 hobby packs.
Nice. Wow. Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. You got to look at what you have in these boxes. Again, you know, maybe you're not a cat fan, but you just pulled a pretty nice card. And yeah, you're doing the right thing, Ivan. I love that you're looking into it. You're clearly a savvy Goodwin collector. You know how this works. It's more, sometimes things are more than meets the eye, right? More than the surface. Absolutely. So yeah, it's awesome.
Well, it's a cool way that you build the product. You know, it's like the base cats, you know, the British short hair, that's a tier one. Come on. The Devon Rex, that's a tier one. Come on. But if you get a serval or a caracal or an Iberian lynx, that's tier three. Though tier four seems reserved for the big boys, mountain lion, clouded leopard, Siberian tiger.
Exactly.
You put the kings in tier four, and that makes sense.
Exactly. Yeah, we kind of try to theme it that way. Yeah, no, I love it. You get it, man. I love that you pick up on that. Yeah, and some people absolutely love those sets. They love collecting the patches. So you pulled one of the cats. There's also a short-printed patch set of sea creatures, too. And the ones I've seen online are awesome, like super colorful. Like really, really nice looking patches. I people are happy when they pull their great white shark patch. That's, you know, 1 in 1,000 packs, 700 packs. So yeah, it's awesome. It's just a different, something different to collect. Something that we don't find in most of our sets. So no, it's awesome. You guys appreciate it.
You know, Tony, do you have anything to do with pursuing licenses over there?
Nice photo choice on this Gaudi mini. Way to go, Tony.
We all talk, we all have those conversations. What are you thinking, Ivan?
So that sea creatures patch checklist, you don't have kids, so you don't know this yet. But trust me, every parent I talk to can sing the creature report song from Octonauts.
Okay.
Octonauts is the absolute best television show for kids. It's like, it's eight people that are in the Octonauts that are like, there's a polar bear, a penguin, a cat, and they live under the sea and they like go meet new sea creatures every episode. I know you guys have done the dinosaurs in the past. I'll bet you there'd be a strong audience out there of children for some Octonauts cards.
All right. I appreciate the the idea with that. I'll definitely pass that along. I'm writing it down now, actually.
Completely selfish, because then I could get my card something other than my kids, something other than the blippy packs when they're at the card store.
So we're always looking to find, to get, you know, the younger generation back into cards. And that's one of the ways to do it. Like, I love all the things that we do with entertainment as well, with, you know, Marvel and all that stuff. You know, it's a whole different group of collectors, but yeah, exactly. Anything that we can get the younger generation back into collecting, I'm all for it. So that's a great suggestion.
I love it. Now, there's another thing as I'm looking at the checklist that I'm actually not seeing, but I could see why you might still have it in there.
Okay.
In the past, you've done the one of one.
Hey, there's world. James Holzhauer.
Oh, hey. I know.
Oh,
that,
yeah. Man. We got a couple of the big Jeopardy guys. It was funny because I was watching it recently. They'd had like their contest of champions, and it was like all these. We have Ken Jennings and Dullhauser. So they were both. Oh, and there's Dullhauser, the volleyball player. But yeah, we had both of them in there. It was cool to see them like going against each other on Jeopardy, like two of the best competitors on that show ever. So
Oh, yeah,
they both made it in the set this year.
You were saying, Ivan, sorry.
No, that's okay. We also were looking at the cards. That's the fun part of it. But I was curious because I pulled one once. The one of one Art of the World, or?
Yes. Art of the Ages. Yeah.
Art of the Ages.
Love Art of the Ages.
So what, are those in
here? What did you
here,
think of
though?
That card?
Oh, it was incredible. It's one of the coolest cards I've ever pulled in my life.
We do love the Art of the Ages.
But it's not in
You'll
here.
Usually keep those as a surprise. I can't promise they're in here, but you might see them in the future. Those are something we're always looking into potentially bringing back, because there's always more beautiful art that we can find. But yeah, we love doing some of those painted cards that we've done over the years. Yeah, Art of the Ages. There's
you're saying
other
you,
one
you
of
took
ones.
A year off for... For
yeah, Goodwin,
year.
We kind of, yeah, if I think that's safe to say. But again, we're always open to bringing back those sets that people love, and that's one we're always considering. But we saved some of the one-of-one kind of content this year for some of like the Apollo 11. We did these really awesome redemptions for oversized relics that have an actual film slide like from the mission that we were able to acquire. It was insane. So it's like an oversized relic. You'll be able to see through the slide relic of, you know, there's shots of them on the moon, with the flag, Earthrise, all sorts of insane stuff. So like there's some other insane one of ones that you can find, but not the Art of the Ages this year.
Okay. Yeah. I'm also noticing the Botanical Wonders jumbo relics are a redemption.
Yeah.
But not one you would complain about, because I imagine that's something you could pack search in an instant, and that's why it has to be packed out that way, right?
Yeah, Goodwin does have a handful of planned redemptions, just cards, again, that are either too big, you know, either dimensionally or too thick, that it just, you know, you'd see a pack that's way too thick, you're going to know it's a, you know, a signature kicks card or something like that. So, yeah, we do choose to do redemptions, planned redemptions for some items
I've
in Goodwin.
Ever seen. This is awesome.
Wow, that turned out really nice. I love that.
Oh, that's funny awesome. That you pulled that. Okay. I was just going to look up the Tiger Lenticular, because I think that's like a must-have card for
that's
personal
awesome.
Collecting.
Just even this is...
Hold on. That, keep that there.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, that looks beautiful. That's the first time I'm seeing that. It looks great.
I was just going to ask, they didn't have you paint those, did they?
No. No, I'm still learning to paint. They don't have me doing that yet. But no, that's someone else's incredible work. That's awesome.
Now, something else we haven't talked about yet is Upper Deck has long had the greatest relationship with Michael Jordan, exclusive relationship with Michael Jordan. And there is a very limited number of specific hits for Jordan in this product, an insert set, a memorabilia set, right?
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, I don't know if you guys have had a chance to watch Last Dance.
Of course.
It was an incredible documentary. I mean, that was very nice of them to move it up for us while we've all been at home to watch, because, yeah, that kept us captivated for quite a few Sundays there. But, yeah, no, you know, I grew up in Chicago. You know, Rob and I have had our talks about, you know, the Tri-Cities and that area. But, you know, growing up watching Jordan, it was incredible to go back and get all those memories and all the things that went on with the team. But we wanted to feature him in something a little different this year's Goodwin. But again, something they didn't touch on in the doc, but again, there's only so much time. But there was a big event in the city of Chicago, which was the last sporting event at the old Chicago Stadium. It was while Jordan was actually playing baseball. Scottie Pippen did a charity game. He said, I want to do a charity basketball game for the city before they tear down the stadium we've won three championships in. So he convinced Jordan to come back and play, and it was loaded. I mean, it was, you know, Pippen, Penny Hardaway, Gary Payton, like all sorts of stud NBA guys in this game. And, you know, Jordan playing baseball said, you know, I'm going to come back and see if I can hang with some of these younger guys. And I think I've read and I believe it's one of the reasons he thought he decided officially I'm going to come back. I think that and playing the Space Jam, you know, league that they kind of set up where they were all playing. They had to set up a whole stadium for him outside. I think those were things that he said, you know what, I can still go out and kick these guys' butt, these young NBA guys, so I'm going to come back. But, you know, it was just an incredible event. He scored, I think, 52 points, made sure his team won, kissed the court, and literally that night they started tearing down the stadium. So we did stadium relics kind of honoring that game. So it's 9 moments from the game. It's a 9-card set, kind of just honoring the game and everything that went on. And then the final card will be signed, hard signed by Jordan. So it'll be a stadium relic autograph card of Jordan. I've seen one redemption of that already pop up on eBay. There's 23 cards of each card, including the auto version. So if you go look up that one on eBay, you'll see the price someone's asking.
What's the relic material from the stadium? Is it the floor? Is it seating?
We have both, actually. Yeah, so we split it up. We have... There's floor, there's seat, and there's brick. So there's three unique mem pieces. So each 3 cards will have brick, 3 will have floor, and 3 will have seat. So it's kind of unique mem throughout the set too. So yeah, if you're a Jordan collector, it's going to be an awesome set to put together.
Oh, because there's also the orange foil GB1 inserts, red foil. So there's a base Jordan card showing him in that jersey that has foil variants that are going for insane amounts on eBay as well. So,
Good, nice. All right.
Surprise to you?
Which card are you referencing? Are you talking about the base cards or are you talking about the blue, floor cards?
Blue. No, just it looks like a base card, but it's got him in that stance.
Okay.
It's a blue foil, a red foil, an orange foil.
Numbered. Right. So, yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about. So Goodwin retail this year is something you guys are also going to want to go check out. See if you can get some. Maybe talk to Chris. Maybe he can get you guys some of that, because it's very unique this year in the sense that a blaster box of Goodwin will yield you, I believe, 6 or 7 packs of just your standard Goodwin cards. But you also get a bonus pack. It's a basketball exclusive. So you'll get 4 turquoise parallels of the base. So that'll be like, again, we talked about the 100 cards. But then you'll also be getting 1 exclusive basketball insert. So that's what you're referencing, Ivan. You're seeing those Jordans, LeBrons, Ben Simmons, some of the big basketball prospects are going to be in the upcoming draft, like Denny Avdija, guys like that. So yeah, you can hit some crazy parallels, low number parallels. I think there's even 1-of-1s, but yeah, those are printed on that beautiful rainbow foil. But yeah, you kind of confused me. Sorry. I thought you were referencing the floor cards and I'm like, there shouldn't be other versions of those.
No. So those are all numbered to 23.
Correct. But yes, except for the 1-of-1s are the retail cards. So yeah, I'm hearing a lot of buzz. I haven't seen them in person, but, I think Goodwin retail is going to be a lot of fun this year too. There's also exclusive auto parallels of those basketball cards in retail as well. So,
hey yeah, Tony might want to point out to the
look at that
pack out facility. I got to get this mini out without damaging it somehow.
You made it. It's like a mini card or something inside there. That was impressive. I have not seen that yet.
Well, if it helps, the British short hair.
I got it. I got it. There we go.
Smooth. That was nice. Well done there. Well done. Everything's intact. Wow. That's awesome.
So we got two cats. I don't know if you, maybe you, you know this, maybe you don't. It's on the checklist though, so I can throw it out there.
Okay.
But so there's 11.
Wow. Hold on 1 second. Oh, yeah. One second.
Uh-oh.
Beautiful subscription, inscription on card numbered to just 50 of Stevie Wise.
Nice. That's there you go. That's who, nice, yeah. Softball nice champ. Card. Go Bruins. Yeah.
Wow. Awesome.
Yeah. Some of the inscriptions this year are incredible. You know, again, our, you know, Brian Schilling, the coordinator who worked on that. Yeah. He came up with some really clever stuff for that. Yeah. Those are going to carry a nice premium. People love that stuff. Anyway, Ivan, sorry, you were talking about the retail cards.
No apologies. That's definitely.
Wait, I'm sorry.
That was well worth it. No worries. But yeah, Ben, keep an eye out for the retail cards as well. There's some special stuff in there, unique to retail this year. So yeah, that's good. You spotted that online.
How old is this stamp? We've got of state Augustus Caesar. Vintage stamp. That's got to be, I'm saying 19, maybe late 1800s. I'd have to check.
Yeah, I don't have the date. I'd have to do some investigating on the date of the stamp. But yeah, those are a new one we tried this year. Yeah, thank you.
The window, the matting. This is beautiful. Well done, Tony.
Awesome. Thank you. Glad you guys like it. Yeah, we tried some different mem cards. We've done map relics in the past. We figured we'd try stamps. You know, we know there's a huge collecting base for stamps, so we wanted to kind of feature some of that. There's also some really nice coin relics you can find, older U.S. currency coin relics. So, yeah, just a variety of items, as you can tell, even from what you've opened so far. But that was a great hit. I like that a lot.
Yeah, fun. Sorry, Ivan. Okay, go ahead. Oh, he quit.
Sorry. No, I'm on mute. I was talking to you. I did some typing. I got a tweet out there for people to retweet to enter to win the hits so that they can hopefully get in and see some of this too before we get away. But who was that on the card? Because we have to check the tier, remember?
Augustus Caesar.
That's right. Ivan's right. You got to check the tiering.
Always got to check the tiering. Augustus Caesar, you will not believe this. Oh, wait, you will. Oh, you mixed it up, Tony. You flipped it on me. So the head of state stamp relics are not group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They're group A, B, C, D. I got all excited because I saw that we hit a group D, but it's actually reverse. Group D is 1 in 2 boxes, so it's not the super rare tier. It's the more common tier, but got a little confused there.
Yeah, that, you know, the group tierings and everything. Yeah, that's, it can get a little involved, but yeah, sorry about that, Ivan.
Yeah,
it's still a nice card.
Fine. It's fine. I just, it'd be nice if it was like, if everyone was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or if everyone was A, B, C, D, you know, the OCD, we're collectors, we're OCD about that, you know.
Good note too, for sure.
Very beautiful card. Don't let collectors little thorns in their sides get in your side. The one thing I saw on the checklist is you mentioned the retail side as well. Well, I think this is just going to make this product incredibly hot. There's 10 basketball cards in that special set.
That's
and
right.
An SP1, which again is Jalen Green.
That's right.
So he not only has those very sparse autographs, he also has one SP base in that special basketball retail set. So
that's right. Yeah. It's, I'm excited to check it out myself. I like to see some, but like from what I've seen of those retail exclusive, those foil cards look awesome. The LeBrons and the other basketball ones that I've seen look really nice, but you're right. We did utilize, some of that same photography from that charity game. So that's what you were referencing with Jordan wearing that same uniform. So it's pretty nice. Another musician in there, Scarface. We got the hip hop community. We have Big Boy from Outkast autographs this year. Really happy with that name. There he is, right on cue. Megan Rapinoe. Miles Bridges, yeah. One of the good, great dunkers right now. Miles Bridges, a really, really great dunker, underrated young player right now. I think he's going to be on the rise year after year for Charlotte. Rose Lavelle, another one of the soccer players. Wayne, there's the suited Wayne you were talking about.
Yep. Well, Mark Henry, former WWE star, now a strong man.
That's right.
This has sure been fun to open because of the eclecticness of it.
Yeah, you just never know pack to pack what you're going to find. You never know what's going to be in there. And, you know, again, all the surprises and short prints. There's some unannounced base variants I think you may have seen online. There's black and whites that are rare. You know, there's the Fanimation cards that are really far out there. I'm waiting to see a Jordan. I've seen a LeBron online. Card looks awesome. We did 10th anniversary retro, so it'll have the 2010 Goodwin like frame design. I've seen that LeBron card, looks really sweet. So there's all sorts of little Easter eggs and hidden things to look for in here.
All right, last pack.
Let's see what we end it with.
The horizontal of Jenny Andrade, Stevie Wise, a mini. Jamie Dwyer, soccer Masit Ozil, and close that out with Alex Morgan. So to review our hits, we'll be giving away Ivan the Augustus Caesar stamp relic card, the Stevie Wise inscribed numbered to 50 autograph.
Awesome.
The British short hair, the Joe Moravsky auto, the Caracal cat patch card, and the Willpower lenticular. Well done, Tony.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Make sure you look through your base. Don't miss out. You might have something else. There's blank backs. You know, like I said, the black and whites, you probably would have noticed. But yeah, there could be something else hiding in your stack. You never know.
All right, my man.
Awesome.
Well, so thank you so much for, yeah, I mean, I really appreciate you. Is that a black and white? Or no, that's just the color splashback is black and white.
You'll know it. Yeah, it'll be stark black and white if you see one. Yeah, that just on the front is what you'll be looking for the black and white variants.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, listen, my friend, this was awesome. I think we're going to have to make this a staple segment every year when Goodwin comes out, okay?
Yeah, I'm in. I love it, guys. Thanks for having me on. This was a lot of fun. Yeah, if you have any more questions, reach out. Lots of mysteries and all sorts of things to discover in that set. So thanks again, guys.
Our pleasure. Thank you, Tony. Have a great night.
You too.
Have a great night. The one, the only, Tony Sirianni. A real pleasure to introduce our audience to him. We met Tony several years ago, not several, a handful of years ago now at the National Sports Collectors Convention when he had to fill in for Chris Carlin during the set collation contest, and he did an awesome job repping Upper Deck, and we've been friends ever since. So it was really good to have him on. You happy, Ivan?
I am so happy. That was awesome. Got me super stoked for the two boxes I ordered today because I love this product. So I got two boxes on the way, and I'm going to go try and chase some every single time I go to the retail store in the next 3 weeks. I'm sure they probably won't even be there on the shelves. They're going to be so hot, but doesn't mean that okay. I'm not going to still chase them, right? Isn't that what we do?
Yep. Write this down. I'm going to give the color splash away. I'll go back through and pull those. And then I'll also pull all the minis. So one winner will get all the minis. One winner will get all the color splash.
Wow. So that's 8 winners. That's incredible. Pretty awesome.
Cool. So, all right. We're going to take a quick break from our box break segment to provide you with this. Last night, Kenny Mayne And Tony Todd, former baseball prospect, you're going to remember Tony, recognize Tony Todd from numerous top spring training videos. He and Kenny Mayne go head to head in a game of Topps 52 card baseball. So it kind of serves as a game demo. It's a short video. Check this out. We'll be right back and then we'll dive into the rest of our box break segments right after this.
Hey, welcome to the first ever recorded Topps 52 card baseball game. We hope to get a real Major League Baseball player on board soon. Right now, we got a guy who almost was, and the greatest celebrity softball player in the history of the game, actor Tony Todd. He's still getting residuals for life from Black Panther, where you got a credit on that movie. Congratulations for that.
Thank you.
Glad to have you
on. That was awesome.
I'm going to run through the rules. You already know them, Tony, but not everybody out there does. Normally, you'd cut this deck in half, right? But we're playing remotely, so we each have a full deck. It's like a deck of playing cards. And they have, for instance, Mike Trout is an ace because he's really good, right? Many of the other players, it's just whatever their number was. Johnny Bench is a five and so forth. So high card prevails always. Tony's going to bat first. So as an example, he throws a five and I throw a six, that'd be a strike. Reverse that, it would be a ball. If he throws higher than I do and it's a face card, a jack's a single, queen's a double, king's a triple, ace is a home run. If both players throw the same card, the runner's on by air, the batter's on by air, and everybody moves up one base. If the pitcher throws a card higher and it's a face card like my jack to his five, that's an out. We're going to play one out per half inning because it smooths the game and moves it along, makes it more realistic. We flip the coin, you're batting first, so the batter announces his play first. Just call it out as you throw. Let's play. The batter's Alex Turner.
Yes. So should I just flip the card?
Flip it and tell us what it is.
What Bam. Is- Whatever.
Tony, just call it out. I can't see that far.
Oh, that's an ace.
You led off with a home run. Alex Turner. Did you stack this?
I did not stack this. I'm telling the truth, brother.
Alex Turner, home run. The batter, Charlie Sheen.
Okay, next card. We have a queen.
Queen is a double. Charlie's on second. Mike McCaffrey comes up.
Come on, Mike. We have a four.
Four to my three. That's ball one. All right, next.
All right.
Ball. What do you got?
You have an ace. You got an ace. An ace.
Ace.
Ace. Yeah, the number eight.
Oh, number eight, you're out because I threw a king. Face card on my side, you're gone. So McCaffrey will say flies out F7. Team diversity on the board, one run. And now bottom of the first, Tommy Harper leading off with a jack. Throw your pitch.
Bam. The nine.
Nine. Base hit for Tommy Harper. All right, remember the stealing rule I didn't go over. The batter looks at his next card. If he likes it, he can say stealing. If it's a ball, he's safe. Strike, he's out. I don't like this card. I got a three. Go ahead.
Okay. Bam, got a five.
Strike one. Tommy Harper's at first. Ken Griffey Sr. Queen.
Got a four.
Griffey with a double. That moves Harper to third. Two runners on for Mark Sansevier. Six.
Got a 10.
Strike one. Seven.
Got a three.
Ball one and one. Stealing with a nine.
Got a three.
Safe all around. Harper steals home. Griffey moves to third. Two and one count to Sansevier. Stealing again. Nine.
Got a nine.
Oh, on by air, that drives in a run. They get the lead, E5, and that'll bring up Henry Aaron, queen.
King.
Oh, long fly ball, Henry Aaron's out. So we've played
See
one.
Ya.
We've played one, it's 2-1, I've taken the lead. All right, here's Joe Hernandez batting for you.
All right, let's go, Joe, here we go. Got a two.
Strike one, I got a six.
All right. I got a four.
I got a four. He's on by air. Catcher dropped a pop-up. That brings up Mitch Lanzini with the runner at first.
Here we go, Mitch. I got a king for Mitch.
I got a king as well. That's another air. Wayne Simpson not getting any help out there. Chip Foose with two runners on.
Let's go. We got a queen for Chip, baby.
Foose knocks in a run, moves another guy to third. They've tied the game here.
So that's kind of cool. So check that out. We had two unclaimed cards from last week, and in my opinion, they were the two biggest hits of the night. We have the Brandon Ayuk patch auto number to 149, and then, believe it or not, Ivan, the Diego Maradona autograph went unclaimed. That's numbered to just 99, so we're going to roll those over this week and try to give those away. Okay.
Wow. I don't believe it.
Next up, we've got a brand new box of Donruss Optic Baseball looking for two autographs. I know we're running a little bit long tonight, so going to pick up the pace on this 20-pack box.
Yeah, that said, it's going to be pretty fun. We're looking for two autographed cards, plus, of course, prisms. There's going to be 10 prisms spread between the 20 packs. A lot of on-card autographs, those ultra-rare inserts, and hot boxes. But love those ultra-rare inserts we've come to expect from Panini. There are Diamond Kings in this, which look pretty cool. Black Stars, All Stars, Rated Rookie Hollows, Retro 1986, Rookies Gold. I love the Highlight Signatures Hollow that has sort of a, is that 1986 Donruss?
Jesus Lizardo, number to 100.
But I'm also not seeing just from the sell sheet what the
Silver
rare
prism
inserts are. Is this the one that has the downtown inserts?
Andrew Vaughn, Rated Rookie.
And it's a 204-page checklist.
He's not kidding.
Go GTS.net. Search it with me.
Blue parallel of Yashitomo Tesago Susuko. Hey! Number to 75.
If we ever need to get our Twitch streaming hours up, just pay me to read the checklist out loud. Live on Twitch, Orange 189, John Means, Baltimore Orioles.
Trey Turner, green parallel, not numbered, but it is a prism. Insert, mythical, little mythical, Cody Bellinger.
Interesting. So I'm trying to scroll through here to find out what's rare and what's not, and I just don't even know. So we're going to have to rely on the
red,
chat.
Red, white, and blue, number 276, as in 1776. Eugenio Suarez.
Wait, is it actually 17 of 76?
No, I don't think so.
It looked like it. It was either 17 or 12.
It's an 11.
Oh, it's an 11. Dang,
that would have been cool, right?
Yeah.
Bryce Harper, Optic Diamond Kings, Prism. Gavin Lux. If you want to see what we pulled on our bonus Twitch break for our subscribers, be sure to check out the replay of that, which is posted on our YouTube channel. Light blue, baby blue parallel, Chris Sale, unnumbered. Illusions, Austin Meadows insert.
So just a reminder, too, if you haven't already, remember twitter.com/goGTSLive is where you vote in the poll, but it's also where you enter to win the hits. So make sure you go there and retweet our tweets to enter to win the hits.
Several people voted for this guy, Kettle Marte, in our poll question by answering other, which is over 602 votes with 9 minutes left. Wow. Anyway, number to 35, funky looking prism. Rated rookie Alex Kirilloff. Javier Baez. Another kind of patriotic parallel there. This one numbered to 76 as well, of Rue. Silver Prism, Forrest Whitley, rated rookie. Gosh, we've been hearing about this guy for, it seems like, 10 years now. Bo Bichette, the rookies. Fernando Tatis Jr. Ooh, a little black Diamond King. Shane Bieber, number to 125. Brendan McKay. Joe Adell. Nice selection of players on this checklist. Brendan McKay again. Freddie Freeman. Orange parallel. Max Scherzer, numbered to 100. Little old school action retro, Jim Rice. Shane Bieber. Red, white, and blue parallel, numbered to 150 of Kevin Biggio. Javi Baez, Diamond Kings. And
ooh, that's little beautiful.
Stained glass Kettle Marte.
Kettle Marte hot box.
Speaking of hot boxes, Ivan, I think there's four in every case, right, of this product?
I'm going to have to go back and check to see if I got distracted. Huck. Looking to see if those stained glass are special. Special or not special. Every card is special, but
Silver Prism Retro, Jose Canseco. Illusions. Yeah, no. So
looks like stained glass or an average insert.
Tell me about, I think there's four hot cases in a 12-box case of this product. Wow, how about Nick Neidhart on a beautiful prism that's on card autograph, not numbered, but really good looking prism card, which makes buying into a case break when you know there's four hot boxes, that's a little added bonus action. Look at this Jorge Soler, wish he was still a Cub. 199. Look at that. That's pretty.
Yeah, so there's the hot boxes actually vary. There are autograph hot boxes and prism hot boxes. So autograph hot boxes will contain five autographs. So that means that a case of, 12 boxes?
And another pink autograph, Adbert Alzolay. Pitching prospect for you guys?
Yep.
Red, white, and blue, Logan Webb, number 2, 150.
So basically the box does not have 24 autographs like you would think. A box really has 30 or a case, sorry, has 30 autographs. And then there's also the prism hot boxes, which will contain 20 numbered parallels. So there's two of those, two autograph hot boxes and two prism hot boxes per case.
Wow. This has been a fun rep. I really, Optic is just a brand that has grown on me every year since its inception. To me, it's the new prism, dare I say. Luis Severino, number to 75. Dylan Cease. And Daryl Strawberry. Joe Palumbo. Future Watch player profile last week, I believe. Learn more about him on GoGTS.net. Black parallel, the guy I think who has a shot at 400 this year, Anthony Rendon, number to 125.
Nice.
Keith Hernandez, retro.
I was just going to say what I'm hearing Bank on It Sports say, which is this feels like a hot box. I haven't seen this many prisms coming out of the breaks I've watched recently. So remember, there's supposed to be 10 prisms in a normal box, but there's 20 numbered prisms.
Oh, yeah. I would say you might be right. I think we did hit one.
Yeah, because there's a lot of different numbered
parallels. Is this the background of this prism showing on camera? Can you see that?
Yeah, the stars.
That is the cool. Universe. I dig that. Shun Yamaguchi, and that's numbered to 125. Aaron Judge. So, Ivan, in addition, what I'm going to do, let's see. With all these numbered parallels and prisms and stuff, let's give them all to one winner. I'll pull them all back out when I ship Saturday. And anybody who took part, well, no, everybody who took part in the Twitch bonus break, I've got your stuff right here. I'm going to ship at the same time. Another silver prism. Illusions.
Is that the first silver prism that we've gotten, actually, though?
Oh, no.
Because they've all been numbered.
Oh, no.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
just
no.
Been flying through. That's all. Right? Makes sense.
Yeah. I've been finding them. Mike Soraka. Dylan Cease, blue, numbered to 75. Ricky Henderson, retro. Last pack. All right. So three winners from this box. The two autos, and I'll go back through, and I'll be sure to grab all the numbered cards.
So big parallels winner.
Freddie Freeman.
And then each of the autos.
Numbered to 75. So, Tracy, you did good. Pulling us a hot box. Mythical, Luis Robert. And Barry Lark, and... So fun. Look, I mean, if you would, all of this color in here is just insane. Very cool. All right.
I like it. So I'm going to go ahead and put a tweet out right now with those hits, and then I'll be right back. But man, I'm excited for this next one. If you're watching, now is the time to tweet out the link because we are about to rip into a box of Panini Obsidian basketball and give away the hits.
This is out of Ivan and I's price range. It's probably out of a lot of your guys' price range at $550 current SRP per box. Thank you, Tracy. Get that put away. Two autographs, seven cards per box. So this is a quicker break. Let Ivan finish up. While he's doing that, I want to give you guys a quick recap of what we pulled in our Twitch break. Absolute memorabilia, crushed it. Look at this beautiful quad patch. Tools of the Trade, Patrick Wisdom. Dylan Carson, quad Tools of the Trade auto, number to 149. Gavin Lux, sweet spot, number to 125. Devi Grulin, number to 125, sweet spot auto. Ichiro, jersey swatch. And then how about a Patrick Sandoval, sweet spot auto with the gold laces, number to just 10. We opened a box of Legacy, gave away the minis, and then we hit this Chris Carson auto numbered to just 15, as well as this beautiful dual patch auto of Jalen Rigor. And then we opened a box of Luminance. And from that, we pulled Darren Woodson jersey swatch, a Ashton Davis rookie auto numbered to 100, De'Aaron Evans rookie auto numbered to 199, and then this beautiful on-card autograph year one insert of Jonathan Taylor. So subscribing to Twitch has its privileges. The winners were already announced. I saw a loaded inbox. I haven't been able to get to the shipping yet, but I will. It's just easier for me to do it all at one time this Saturday. All right, Ivan, are you ready? You back with us?
I'm back with us. I was able to tweet it out myself, so you have no excuse not to tweet it out. Let friends and people know, because guess what? The more people watch, the more we lean on Tracy, the more we lean on Carlin, the more we lean on Emily, and the more stuff we get to give away to you. So send it out via social media right now, because we are going to dive into a sick box of basketball cards, 2019-20 Obsidian. Each box is going to deliver two autographed cards plus two
Do we lose him? All right, so we lost Ivan. He'll come back. Oh, there you are. All right. All right, let me take it from here, bro. Myers Leonard for the Miami Heat. Little purple laser etching. Oh, he's back. All right.
Yep.
Number to 75.
Sorry, I was all excited too. 70. I got so excited I knocked the bandwidth out.
Jrue Holiday. How about a little die cut action of LeBron James?
Oh, and that card what do you mean a little?
99.
What do you mean a little die cut action?
Yeah, that's beautiful.
That's incredible. If you've been following anything. Called. Yeah, can hold it there for a second. On the front. Yeah, if you've been following anything in the world of basketball cards, you know that inserts of guys like LeBron and Giannis and Luka are just going insane right now. That's a great hit right there.
Luke Kennard. All right, let's see what we got. Wow, going old school, James. George Mirasan, number 77 for the Washington Bullets. And last card, Chuma Okoki, number 75. Very nice.
So that's been my guy all year. Every time I've wanted a Zion or a Ja, I've gotten a Chuma. Sorry I brought that with me into the show, but that tunnel vision LeBron is absolutely awesome. And actually the last time I complained about pulling Chumas, I had like 10 people tweet at me that they were collecting him. So that's the other cool thing about cards is there's always somebody collecting it, right?
Absolutely. So those are the three cards we'll give away from that break. And that wraps up our live box break segment of the evening with a little bonus action from Tony Sirianni, product development lead at Goodwin, or four Goodwin champions from Upper Deck.
Woo! Do you want to guess at that LeBron card? Like what the last one sold for?
140?
190. So there you go, $200 insert.
180 came to my mind first, and I said, nah, that seems high, but I should have gone with my gut. All right, updating the poll question, which is now closed in the shortened MLB season. Who is most likely to hit 400? And I just didn't come up with these names on my own. I asked Google, and I looked at three or four different articles, and I pulled three names that were amongst multiple articles. Cody Bellinger, Yordan Alvarez, Mike Trout, or other. The results didn't skew very much since the beginning, but a lot of people weighing in with other at 22.4. Mike Trout at 44.8% leads the way. We'll see if it happens at all, but thank you everyone for weighing in. 620 votes. All right, let's shift gears now and dive into what's going to be hot in the shop. hot at your online retailer and hot with your favorite group case breaker next week in this segment of Hot in the Shop. And we kick things off with 2020 Topps Museum Collection Baseball Cards, which is going to deliver one autograph relic card, one autograph signed on card, and a quad relic hit, plus a regular relic card. So there's 12 boxes in a case, four mini boxes and a master box. So if you did the math there, yep, every mini box will have a hit in it, along with other cards. So the autograph relic, an autograph signed on card, a quad relic, and a relic card. Also chase three case hits, museum collection framed autograph cards, and jumbo relic autograph cards. The archival autographs subset is 100 players with on-card autographs in various low-number parallel. Look for the superstar showpieces. And in addition to that, we've got dual on-card autographs, numbered to 15 or less, triple on-card autographs, numbered to 5 or less, plus those one in every case museum framed parallels or framed autographs with parallels in silver to 15, gold to 10, black to 5, wood one of ones. Museum framed autograph patch cards with jumbo game used jersey swatches, patches rather. Ivan, you're rubbing off on me. With on card autographs, and then the museum framed dual autograph patch book cards, 15 dynamic pairings with on-card autos and jumbo game used patch pieces. There is so much going on in this set, and it's absolutely beautiful. It's scheduled for release a little late, but it's here next week.
Rob, I'm pretty excited. Soccer has been on fire, and this week we get a super high-end soccer release. Panini Impeccable Premier League soccer cards. Now, if you know soccer at all, you know that the league or the clubs are what matter in a checklist. Well, this product looks incredible because all 20 Premier League clubs are represented and celebrates players from past and present across 15 unique autograph inserts. So there's going to be tons of patch autographs with Premier League materials, such as the Elegance inserts. And just look at the size of some of those patches and the designs of some of those patches. There's the cool Stainless Stars inserts with autographs printed on steel. Steel cards with autographs on steel. There's also the Club Story with some absolutely great history of the club, along with top players and champion signatures. Here's the biggie. So much Cristiano Ronaldo Manchester United product in this, or different cards to collect from what we've seen from them so far. Also look for impeccable trio signatures with stunning triple autograph cards showcasing three players from the most storied clubs. And of course, rookie autographs. You need the first autographs of some of the brightest budding superstars in the Premier League. Go back in time with all-time legends with more than 15 great legends of the game. And then, of course, be on the hunt for special inserts featuring slabs of precious metal engraved with the Premier League logo. Check that out. There's a gold
sale
from Liverpool FC. Tons of great content in this, as well as a 100-card base set showcasing top stars. This is going to be really awesome and really hot for soccer collectors to chase this week, Hot in the Shop.
Awesome. I was able to really quickly, before you start the next video, go back and pull the color from that prism break. And yes, it was definitely a hot box. And I blew by a Trey Turner green that was numbered 5 of 5. So lots of good stuff there. And that will give away to one lucky winner. Okay, next up and hot in the shop, 2020 Donruss Elite NFL football cards, featuring this year's rookies in their professional uniforms for the first time. Awesome. Two autograph cards, including one pen pal auto, plus one memorabilia card, three rookies, 6 parallels, and 8 inserts in every box. One of the season's most exciting brands comes packed with new inserts, new designs, and all of the top rookies, many of whom are highly touted in this much-hyped draft class. The always anticipated Pen Pals and Pen Pal Duels feature on-card autos of the top rookies, come in one per box on average, as mentioned, with lots of colored parallels, including new purple ink variations. Love it. And we've had really good luck when we've with those boxes in the past. Turn of the Century, one of the most collectible rookie autograph sets of the year, all numbered to 199 or less. Back to the Future, another long staple in Elite. And one memorabilia card in every box, including things like Spark Plug and the all-new Swagger, a multi-swatch memorabilia card, 100-card Elite base set, and more when this hits stores next week.
Rob, we have another exciting set of Chronicles cards. This time it's Panini Chronicles NBA basketball cards. Each box is going to deliver 2 autographed cards in every box. But, Rob, it's funny. I'm getting to the point where that's not even the highlight anymore.
With
the way they're building these out, it's like, yeah, there's 2 autographs. But Chronicles brings together so many cool different brands all under one umbrella. So look for things like these awesome, I mean, look at that Airborne Signatures card. That's just great looking. There's going to be Hall of Fame autographs in these. There's going to be Rookie Cornerstones Onyx. So a little pulling from the Cornerstones brand, a little pulling from the Limited brand, some Prism Update. So some people that maybe didn't get to see action shots of them in the original Prism, you can find their Prism Update Gold in this product. Hometown Heroes rookie autographs. There's the base titanium draft position. There's Gala. There's Vanguard. All kinds of incredible brands coming in with rookie autographs and veteran autographs and retired star autographs. Those Gala are ultra rare, just FYI, if you find yourself breaking a box. And there's also limited rookie jersey autograph cards. So check out Chronicles. I mean, it's just going to be popular. There's no other way to put it.
Well said. Super Break has been on a roll with themed products based on jersey numbers of different players. So the next up is Super Break Baseball number 2 and number 24 edition. 1-2 premium buyback hits in every box, featuring MLB's greatest players to wear jersey numbers 2 or 24. Every team's represented, and group break spots should be about $50 or less. Each case is guaranteed to contain a minimum of 2 buyback hits, one from a player that wore jersey number 2 and one that wore jersey number 24. This product also features the debut of the Bar Baseball Super Foil Cut Auto and Memorabilia 101s. Look for it in stores or at your favorite breaker next week.
And we have a new twist on the Donruss Optic that we just showed you, 2020 Donruss Optic Choice Baseball Cards. Slightly different configuration. Each box is going to deliver 3 autographed cards, along with 5 Choice Exclusive Prisms in every box. So you're going to have multiple exclusive parallels like Red Dragon, Green Dragon, Liberty, and Freedom Prisms, as well as 2 silver prisms that you can expect from this as well. So they're not getting rid of your silvers. We know how much you love your silvers. There's just bonus content. So again, look for the highlight signatures, look for the rated rookie signatures, the rated prospect signatures, but then it's also paired in with that special choice exclusive prisms across the 200 card base set and the Diamond Kings. So that could be pretty cool. So a new chase factor added with 2020 Optic Choice Baseball hitting hobby shops this week.
Yeah, it looks pretty cool with some of those red and green dragon prisms.
Oh, there they are. There they are. Yeah. Yep. And again, so they come on, you can get them on the Diamond Kings as well, which I think is pretty awesome.
Yeah, I love it. I mean, and it's also loaded with on-card autographs, which is really great. Not only rated rookies, but rated prospect signatures as well. Mm-hmm. Some of the top 20 prospects in the league. It's really cool. I'm excited to take a look at that SKU. Hope we can get it. All right, next up, we have a memorabilia product from TriStar. This in the form of Hidden Treasures Autograph Football Mini Helmets Platinum Edition. One autograph football mini helmet in every box. Look for Hall of Famers, top 2020 draft picks, NFL stars, fan favorites, and more. Your case guarantees in the 8-box case is going to deliver 6 Hall of Famers and 2 current star. Excuse me. Hold on. Let me back up there. Yeah. And 2 current stars. But in addition to that, you're going to find 3 inscribed helmets and 2 specialty helmets. Those specialty helmets, you know them, either the Chrome, Ice, Blaze, Color Rush, Tribute, etc. So in every case, you're going to find 3 inscribed and 2 specialties in addition to the player guarantees. Top draft picks, Joe Burrow, Tua, yep, they're in there. Current stars, Brady, Mahomes, yep, they're in there. Hall of Famers, Montana, Namath, yep, they're in there. All autographs authenticated by TriStar, PSA, JSA, or BAS. And look for randomly sorted upsized tickets redeemable for various autographed full-size helmets from NFL stars, including guys like Tom Brady. So be in stores next week as well.
Hey, Rob.
Yeah?
You're going to have some work to do this next week.
Uh-oh, what did I do?
You're going to have to go update the exhaustive, comprehensive actor and entertainer trading card autograph list, because we've got an exciting new product, season 1 of a pretty popular television show, The Umbrella Academy, which has been on Netflix for a couple years now. I think it's in season 3, maybe.
I got to dive into this.
Yeah,
it's based off a comic book, right?
I think so. I think so. It was like, it literally came out right when, not when the kids were being born, like right after they were through the, we got to watch a lot of TV first 4 months of them, you know, because you get that with kids.
Sure.
So I haven't gotten to see it. I only saw the trailer like 3 times, but I'm probably gonna have to do it now. But enough about us. Let's talk about the Umbrella Academy. Well, it's an entertainment product. Each box is going to have 2 hits, including 1 guaranteed autograph signed on card, as well as 3 bonus chase insert cards from the chase sets. The autograph checklist looks great. Some names you know, Ellen Page, Colm Feore, and then some of the up-and-comers as well. Cameron Britton, Jordan Clare Robbins, Emmy Raver Lampman, Aidan Gallagher. So always fun with these products, because you never know which of these actors could go on to great things or which of them could never sign again. You know, how often has Ellen Page been in autograph sets? I don't know, but you have a chance to get her card here. There's also relic cards that are autographed and dual autographed cards, as well as sketch cards and then that aforementioned chase insert sets. Get this, there's a 9-card acetate starring characters set. While she's not on the checklist for your autographs, you can get a Mary J. Blige acetate card. Got to double check if that's a rookie card or not. So check that out and go to gogts.net for some additional case incentives. If you're a big entertainment collector and want to rip a bunch of this, there's some exciting case bonuses if you buy 6, 9, or 18 cases. So check that out.
Awesome. And that wraps up our look at next week's new releases with Hot in the Shop. All right, we are gonna put Ivan to work and giving pulling winners for several winners, including the 2 rollover winners of the Diego Maradona and the Brandon Ayuk cards. So that's cool. So get to work on that. But in the meantime, we have a special announcement from GoGTS Live. All right, guys, we're really excited to announce that our official app is now available for download through the Google Play Store. This initial version is a simple and convenient app that allows easy mobile access to everything you love about the show. We'll walk you through it real quick. The live icon takes you to our Twitch stream, which is only active when we are broadcasting. Sometimes it just pulls up we're offline. Sometimes it pulls up your internet's broken. That's a Twitch API thing. They'll figure that out eventually. The watch icon takes you to a replay of the previous show on YouTube. And then the listen icon provides access to the audio portion of the previous week's show on SoundCloud. The one of the cool features
you can
is
do
that
while you drive.
Yeah, exactly. Thanks, Ivan. The win / Twitter icon provides a simple way to not only access our Twitter feed, but makes retweeting the prize tweets super convenient. And then the web icon takes you to the show's webpage, where you can then access things we've discussed on the show, as well as past box breaks, past episodes, and everything else. And we've even used some of your extremely kind words received via email in the testimonies icon, so that when people are going through the store and happen to come across it and they check it out and they go, wow, these people have really nice things to say about the show. Maybe we can grow the audience a little bit. And yes, we haven't forgotten about you. Don't worry, iPhone users. We are working on an iOS version as well, hoping to have that up in the next 7 to 10 days. We'll obviously keep you posted with that. So please go download that from the Google app or Google Play Store. If you are an Android user, we'd greatly appreciate it. And that's it. So back to prizes. Ivan.
I was going to say that's actually just going to make their lives easier. It's kind of cool and kitschy for us to say we have it, but it really makes the viewers' lives easier. They don't have to jump around as much. And I was just thinking the other day, I was like, man, I wonder what we pulled in that break way back then of that product. No surprise, a soccer product. And I was like, how do I find that? Well, we put it all in one place for you now, so you can go back and see past performance, even though it's not indicative of future results.
Yeah, email us at the show if you run into any bugs that need to be fixed or have any content suggestions. Obviously, this is, you know, the first of what will probably hopefully be many versions. But we think we put enough there to get things going for now and, you know, just to get something up on the App Store, which is a process in and of itself. So, yeah, we're excited.
All right. So, Rob. I just pulled from the other three. Don't worry. Calm down, people. We got you. We would never do you wrong. That's what we're here for. I'm a little salty because I had an eBay buyer that was yelling at me today. So sorry to bring my salt towards you, my wonderful friends. I miss you. Rob, I miss the National. It's going to be sad this year. Yeah. I was already thinking of the people I need to email just to send them something special to say I miss you. But that said, that's why the show is here. So don't stress. Everybody who retweeted the other three is going to have an entry for the extra bonus ones. So we got you. That said, do remind your friends if they only watched on Periscope, one, that they're missing out because Twitch is where it's at. Hi, Facebook and live stream watchers. I miss you guys, but my bandwidth is too low. And also, if you are watching on Twitch and you have Amazon Prime, you can subscribe for free to be entered into those bonus box breaks that we are going to start doing more regularly that we just did this last week, just by subscribing for free with your Twitch, your Amazon Prime subscription. So do that because it helps us defray the cost of shipping. It doesn't even offset it, just helps us defray. But we're going to talk about that now. So I've got 16 winners. I can't say I've got them to give away because Rob's the one who does all the shipping. So shout out to Rob. Be kind to him. We've got 16 things to give away. If you hear your name called, email us with your name, your Twitter handle, your mailing address, and what you won so we can match it all up easily. Those four things. Email us at gogtslive@gogts.net. Ignore that. It's the full Go GTS Live. But Just the name of the show at the name of the website. Very, very easy. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Rob, they might be slightly out of order for you, so roll with me here. Sorry for the audible, so to speak.
No worries.
But we'll make it work. So we've got 6 hits from Goodwin Champions to give away, starting off with a Augustus Caesar stamp, Group D stamp, which sadly is not the big group, but hey, we hit one from a big group, so we'll talk about that later. That's going to De Great Rubini. Congratulations, De Great Rubini. You won that. Next up, the Stevie Weiss autograph softball player from the Bruins is going to Beth Lynn 16. Congratulations, Beth Lynn 16. This is important, Rob. Make sure that these people get the right cats. The British short hair. The British short hair. That's going to Go Outside Guy. And the Caracal. Somebody find out how do you pronounce that and get that to me. It's going to Leanne Burden. Leanne Burden. So congratulations to you both. Those are awesome cards. Next up, the Joe Morofsky autograph is going to Cards No Co. N-O-C-O. Cards No Co. And then the Willpower Lenticular card, Lenticular Color Splash, which looks beautiful, is going to Master DPK. Congratulations, Master DPK. All right, then we also said we were going to give away...
Yeah, the minis.
The minis and the color splashes. I pulled winners for those as well. So the color splash is going to Heatwave 316. Heatwave 316. And then the minis are going to One and Only Fall Guy. Congratulations, One and Only Fall Guy. All right, next up we have Donruss Optic, starting off with that Cub Adbert Alzolay. The Cub pitching prospect that hopefully we'll see up. I haven't checked the Cubs roster yet and seen if he made it this year yet or not. But that's going to Sweeney 24. Congratulations, Sweeney 24 on the Adbert Alzolay. And then the Nick Neidhart auto, which I saw a few of you's tweets saying he's under the radar. Good sleeper. You're excited. Well, Corey of the Wood, I hope that you're excited because you just won that card. Congratulations, Corey of the Wood on the Nick Neidhart auto. And then we also are going to give away the parallels from that hot box of Donruss Optic. That's going
look at
to,
this. Ooh, yeah. Look at this.
Let's see how big that stack is.
One number to 5, one number to 35 in there.
Ooh, I missed the number to 5. Who was that?
Yeah, I missed it too the first time. This green Trey Turner, numbered 5 of 5.
Oh, wow. Trey Turner, numbered 5 of 5. That's pretty awesome. Well, congratulations. Congratulations, Rosemary Eaker. Rosemary Eaker, you won the parallels. So I know you've won in the past, so you should know how to claim. Congratulations. All right. Now going to Obsidian, we start off with the veteran auto, George Mureschan, the Giant. That's going to 714 Sports Cards. James's Giant. 714 Sports Cards won that George Mureschan auto. And then the Chuma Okeke autograph is going to IT Guy 8706. 8706. And then the LeBron James Tunnel Vision is going to the Dingo Dude. The Dingo Dude. Congratulations on the LeBron James Tunnel Vision. You said it's a Tunnel Vision to 99, right? Not to 25, because
yeah.
They have both. Okay. All right. So that said, we've still got 2 incredible bonus autographs. So thank you for sticking around. Thank you for watching the show tonight. Thank you for your engagement. I know it was a long one. We had a lot of fun, though. First up is that Brandon Ayuk auto. That's going to Aaron Berry 11. Congratulations, Aaron Berry 11. And then the Diego Maradona auto. I've seen a lot of familiar names tonight. This is a name I have not seen yet. So congratulations on possibly your first Go GTS Live win. 66NHL. 66NHL. I hope that as a hockey fan, you don't also mind the parallels between hockey and soccer and winning that awesome Diego Maradona. So those were the winners.
Awesome. Well done, Ivan.
Hey, well done, Rob. A fun show. Well put together. Thank you for all your work doing that.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you. All right. So that's going to put a wrap on things here for this episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. We're going to be back live next week on Thursday with a brand new episode. And then we come right back the next night to join Bench Clear Media for Hobby Palooza at our same time slot, 9 p.m. Eastern time. So you get a two-for-twofer next week. And it'll be a little bit different format on the Friday night. And we're going to focus on chatting with some people in the hobby. But
are we Friday or Saturday?
Show. I thought we were Saturday. I thought you said Friday. Friday's the 31st. I think that's what you texted me. But anyway, we'll figure it out.
I'll find out in a minute.
You'll find
out.
Who
knew I had
sure
this many DMs in the last?
Well, no, I mean, by next Thursday, we'll know for sure and can sort that out for you. But in the meantime,
8-1.
So that's Saturday. Okay. Yeah. So we do get a rest day.
Well, I just wanted to make sure you knew also, because I know that you, like me, have family. And so it's like, wait a minute, a Saturday, we got to make sure. But yeah.
Yeah. I got to check too. Yeah. Okay. But thank you to Tony Sirianni from Upper Deck, Chris Carlin for sending out the product, Tracy Hackler from Panini America. Wow, hooking us up with the Obsidian. I mean, $550 crazy a box. Thank you. Again, thanks to all our Twitch subscribers. Thank you to everybody that watches, regardless of the platform which you choose to watch. And again, download the GoGTS Live app, give it a whirl, and we'll be back next week. For James Gale behind the scene, Ivan Lovegren, I'm Rob Bertrand. Have a great weekend, everybody. And you know what to be doing. Until next week, always be collecting. See you later.